can't say as I disagree philosophically with what Mark just said. The only thing I can tell you is that that horse, as bad as I despise that horse on a desert, is untouchable under federal law. We have had numerous attorneys try and work through the federal laws with the BLM so that we can get some kind of a contract, some kind of negotiations with the BLM to get them off of there. And that was as best as we could do. That's as good as we could do, Sebastian. Well, that's all it is. Am I happy with what we have? No, I think there are too many holes in it. But we did also confer with Karen Bud Fallon to see how she would like to do some of those things. And she, knowing the laws of the Mustang and the wild horse, also agreed with some of the things we had in there. We had over 3 or 4 months of many attorneys working on that. But the BLM will always use the excuse we don't have any funding for it. In the last appropriation bill, I tried to talk to Rob Bishop and also Jason Chaffetz to try and put a line item in the federal budget, specifically $1 million, $2 million, I don't care what it was, on capturing and removal of horses off the desert. And they couldn't get it in there because now it's classified as an earmark. In my opinion, that's the only way we're going to get these things done. We have probably 100-fold more horses on our lands than the lands will hold. And believe me, we have tried hard. My predecessor worked hard. Our staff worked hard. And we did sue, and we did win, and that's why we tried to do this. And if they don't live up to it, we're going to sue them again.
That sounds good, Dave. We know you're new in the job. We appreciate working with you. You're a rancher, a cowman, and these guys respect that. So we're going to work on that. Let's get these last three.